Friends, I'm meteorologist Ashley Ruiz. It is 9:16 on this Monday morning. We're coming to you live on brproud.com and on the free BR Proud app. We'll go ahead and clip this and put it on Facebook a little later. We were trying to go live and I'm having some technical difficulties with that. But all in all, you can find this. If you do miss this this morning when it's live, you can always find it on brproud.com and we'll post it there. So we're talking about the tropics. It's pretty active. In fact, when we were talking this time last week on Friday, it was quiet, but we did mention that there could be a few tropical waves in the coming days. Well, now we have several tropical waves, one of which is currently focused over Cuba right now. So the one that we will be tracking later on the week is a tropical wave that is between Cuba and the Bahamas right now. As it moves into the southeastern Gulf on Tuesday, it will enter a more favorable environment for some development. Currently, it is battling some wind shear, but the upper level winds, mid level winds will be a little more favorable for some gradual development. So we'll have to watch this in the coming days. By Wednesday, it will be in the central Gulf of Mexico, and then by Thursday, potentially starting to move closer to Texas. What you're seeing right here, this one little X on your screen, that is an area of low pressure, a surface low pressure that has developed. This was the tropical wave that brought us some wet weather, more so close to the coast just yesterday, going to bring us some wet weather today as well, but more so southwest Louisiana and into Texas. And then this wave that you see in the main development region, this is usually when we have waves come off Africa and they track like so toward the Windward Islands. This one is currently in the central Atlantic, has a low chance for formation. So I'll break these all down for you in full detail. As for right now, it's 85 degrees. Again, it's 9:18 in the morning. We have an east wind at 10 miles per hour and you see some beautiful cumulus clouds in the sky. This morning, the rain is really confined from Morgan City, even close to New Iberia, Lafayette, but the heaviest of rain is really over Vermilion Bay, Atchafalaya Bay this morning, and then closer to Abbeville. Where you are seeing this green color, that is a marginal risk for excessive rainfall or flooding today. That is a level 1 out of 4 on the scale from marginal to high in terms of excessive rainfall. So areas all the way from Houma, Thibodeau, Pierre Part, and then closer to Lafayette, to Lake Charles, and then the coastal areas will have the potential to see some heavy rain, which could lead to some isolated flash flooding. And this is all associated with that first wave or that area of low pressure that is just near the coast of Texas. So a closer look at some of these thunderstorms, you kind of see that counterclockwise circulation. It's starting to wrap around this area of low pressure, and this is exactly where it is right now. So the tropical wave area of low pressure, eventually it will push inland toward Texas either later tonight or into early Tuesday. Now, can this gradually begin to intensify a little bit? Maybe a little. The National Hurricane Center is giving it around a 10% chance for formation through the next 2 days. Again, supposed to move into Texas. But that's not to say that it can't become a weak depression. Can't rule that completely out, but the National Hurricane Center is saying that chance is pretty low at the moment. As for that one tropical wave we were telling you about that is over Cuba and then near the Bahamas, that has a 20% chance for formation. So yes, the chance is low, but as we know with hurricane season, that percentage can definitely go up. Just something we have to watch. And then that other one in the main development region, that has a low chance for formation as well. So thankfully, again, we do have low chances for formation. But keep in mind, we are not even at the peak of hurricane season. And forecasters are expecting this to be an above normal season. We've already had 6 and total named storms. CSU, Colorado State University, is forecasting around 20 total named storms, and that includes the 6 we've already seen. NOAA between 13 and 19, and they're forecasting 6 to 10 hurricanes. 3 to 6 of those will be major hurricanes. So again, we're not even at the peak of hurricane season. To kind of show you where we are in terms of hurricane season, still have ways to go. I would say by now we're getting closer to August 1st, obviously, and then as we head throughout August, that's when we start to see increased tropical activity. The peak season, climatologically speaking, this is the number of storms per 100 years. And you can see the peak season usually is around September 10th, but then things start to continue. Previous years, we've seen storms, strong storms in October and into October, or October and into mid-October as well. And then keep in mind, the end of hurricane season is at the end of November. So we still have ways to go. Now, with the first area of low pressure, the one that is currently off the Texas coast, we'll still see some rain with that. But going forward into the middle half of the week, we'll have better shots for rain. Today, our area around 40% for some wet weather. That will kind of decrease a little bit on Tuesday before increasing once again Wednesday, but especially Thursday and into Friday. So to run through the future cast for you, this afternoon we'll see some scattered showers and thunderstorms at least till around maybe 6 o'clock or so. Tuesday, the same goes. We'll just have some pop-up showers and thunderstorms, mainly during the afternoon and evening. Things will quiet on down Tuesday night before rain chances increase back into the forecast on Wednesday. But even then, it's not going to be a total loss, not a total washout. Thursday and Friday we'll have some better chances for some rain. The Weather Prediction Center for the next 5 days is showing the heaviest of rainfall should be confined to the coast. You see these purple colors, that's anywhere between 1.5 to 2.5 inches of rain. And you see this orangish color, that is indicating closer to 4 inches of rain. Of course, that is offshore. The Baton Rouge Metro showing anywhere between 1/4 of an inch up to about 1 inch. But when we have stronger thunderstorms, as we know here in South Louisiana, you could double or triple that amount. But that is isolated spots, of course. And to kind of walk through some of the models in terms of the next few days, this is the European model showing anywhere between 1/10 of an inch for our area all the way down to about 1/2 of an inch, a little more than 1/2 of an inch near the coast. But this is through Friday morning. As for the GFS model, showing a little higher than that, and that would be through Friday morning as well, again, with the heaviest of rains staying to our west and to our southwest and closer to the coast. So it's just something we're going to be watching in the coming days, not expecting rapid development or anything like that, but as it pushes across the Gulf of Mexico, which again, it'll enter the Gulf Tuesday and then move into the central Gulf of Mexico by Wednesday, and then by Thursday it should be mainly south of our area and pushing towards Texas. But the current little X you see right here, that is that area of low pressure that just developed. So that's tropical wave number one. This is tropical wave number two. Tropical wave number two will increase our rain chances later in the week. Tropical wave number three, that's still way out there. So again, we'll continue to follow this and keep you posted. As for your 7-day forecast, again, today it's still going to be hot, still going to be humid. We'll see a high near 91. It already feels like the mid and upper 90s out there. We'll see triple digit heat indices. Rain chances will begin to increase Thursday and into Friday. But again, the heaviest of rain is still expected to stay near the coast and potentially to our west and southwest. But this could always change. By the weekend, we'll start to enter that typical summertime pattern that we have pretty much every day here in South Louisiana, where we see pop-up showers and thunderstorms with temperatures where they should be this time of year in the lower 90s. So what you can go ahead and do, download the free BR Proud app so you can get any updates on the tropics, on our local weather, local news, of course, sports, all that you need in the palm of your hand. It's free, of course, and all you have to do is go to the Google Play Store or the Apple Store, and you can download it. It's a very cool tool to have. You can track the tropics along with us, and you can track thunderstorms that pop up in your area. There's an interactive radar, great tool to have. And then, of course, you can always find the latest on brproud.com as well. So if you have any questions, just send me an email, aruez@brproud.com, or you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and we'll continue to track the waves that are in the Gulf. Gulf of Mexico. No immediate concern except that we are expecting some wet weather today, 40% chance for rain. And then starting Wednesday, but more so Thursday and Friday, we'll have increased rain chances. Of course, that is all dependent on what happens with that second tropical wave, but you can always find it right on brproud.com, the free BR Proud app, and on our social media platform. So enjoy your day. If you hear thunder, be sure to head indoors, stay cool, and stay dry out there. We'll see you later.